Hi, Chuck Huber here for the Stata YouTube channel. I'd like to show you how to use the margins plot command. If you haven't already watched the margins videos, you might want to watch those first, as those may be useful for understanding how margins plot works. So let's open some example data by going up to the top left here and selecting File and Example Datasets from the menu, and click Stata 12 Manual Datasets and Base Reference Manual, and then we're going to scroll down to margins plot. Here, and we're going to be using the NHANES 2 data again, so click Use, and that will open the data from across the web. Now let's start by fitting a linear model. So let's select Linear Models and Related, Linear Regression. By the way, this will work with logistic regression or other things, but we're just going to stick with linear models for now. We're going to build a model for systolic blood pressure, so for our dependent variable, let's select BP systole. For our independent variables, we're going to use a factor variable, so let's click this three-dot box over here on the right and leave factor variable selected, and we just want a main effect here for now, so let's, under variables, select age group. And for the base category, we're just going to use the default. Now let's click add to var list. Stata's added that here at the bottom. So click OK, and then we click OK again, and Stata fits the regression model for us. And we have coefficients estimated for age groups 2 through 6, as well as the intercept, the constant here at the bottom. And now we might want to look at some linear predictions from our model. So we can go back up to statistics and use the margins command. So let's scroll down under statistics to postestimation, and go to marginal means and predictive margins, so select that. And in this dialog box, in the main tab, let's just select under factor terms to compute margins for, let's select age group and click OK, and Stata computes the marginal predictions for us. So for group 1, the age group 1, the 20 to 29 year old group, the predicted systolic blood pressure would be 117.3 and change, and so forth for each group. Now, the table is very useful, and it might reproduce well for your purposes, but sometimes we might want to view the results graphically. So let's go back up to statistics and scroll down to post-estimation again, and this time let's select margin plots and profile plots. So click that, and in this dialog box, in the main tab, in the very top row here where it says variables that define the x-axis, let's select age group, it's the only variable in our model at this point, and click submit, and Stata will actually graph those predictions for us using the grouping variable across the horizontal axis and show the linear predictions on the vertical axis. So for example, the 20 to 29 year old age group, the linear prediction is just a little less than 120, and the 95% confidence interval for that prediction is shown around it with little whiskers. Same thing with the 30 to 39 year old age group and 40 to 49 and so forth. Now these are connected with a line which seems to give the impression that age is continuous, but it's not. These are actually discrete categories. So if we wanted to remove the line to emphasize the fact that these are categories, we could click on the plots tab, and under plot type we could change connected to scatter and then click submit. And now we've removed the lines, which I think sort of emphasizes the fact that age group is actually a categorical variable and doesn't confuse people with the idea that maybe age is actually a continuous variable here. Now one last thing, sometimes people like to transpose these graphs, transpose the axes. So if we go back and click on the main tab and scroll down where it says swap the x and y axes horizontal graph, check that box, and now we can click OK. And that has actually transposed the graph. So now on the horizontal axis we have the linear predictions, the values for those, and on the vertical axis we have the age groups. Okay, and then we can see the actual predictions along here. Some people call these TIE fighter graphs if you're a Star Wars fan. So, okay, so that's just a very basic introduction to margins plot. I hope it was helpful, and thanks for stopping by.